Welcome to the Economy and Politics Show. I'm Ottoabasi Abasiekong. In this edition, Africa comes to the fore, a continent in the last two decades which had bleak prospects of growth and transformation, but has now turned to become the centerpiece for global attention and investment destination. We look at Africa's story of transformation, stable reforms, even in the political economic aspect. Notable financial analyst in the region, Mr Bismark Rewane, CEO of Financial Derivatives, gives us an insight to how Africa has become stable and has become a key market for engagement in the globe.
First and foremost, the rhetoric and the narrative has changed. Africa was known for disease, for ignorance, for conflict, and for low education and all of that. But yeah, now you look at what's happening today, the narrative has changed. It's more about investment destination. All the African heads of states were taken to the United States in August to have a meeting with the United States. Africa, Chinese trade with Africa is $200 billion, while American trade with Africa is $90 billion. So this is the place to be at this time. The African context today, Africa is growing at a rate of almost 5%, 5.3%. China is growing at about 7.5%, and the rest of the advanced economies are growing at much lower rates, even though we are starting from a smaller and a lower base. Seven of the world's fastest growing economies are in Africa, number one being South Sudan, 24.7, Sierra Leone, number two, at 13.3, Liberia, 8.1, Cote d'Ivoire, 8, Ghana, 7.9, Rwanda, 7.5, and Mozambique, 7%. The overall size of the African economies have tripled since 2002.
With this unique and wonderful analysis, which puts Africa at a good pedestal, we now look at some key issues that Africa must take seriously if it must gain advantage in its engagement with other regions in the globe. The first that comes to bear is the issue of it boosting its competitiveness. In the last report for 2014-2015 of the Global Competitive Index developed by the World Economic Forum, only one African country emerged out of the first 50 out of 144 assessed in the index as a competitive economy. Mauritius emerged 35th, and this is not good for a continent that is supposed to be the last frontier transforming and becoming a key player in the globe. What should government and the private sector do? The public and private sector partnership should look at investing in research and innovation, which will unlock the enormous potentials in Africa, bringing to bear challenges that have plagued the continent. Solutions will come from these investments. Also, the issue of enterprise development. Africa has a fast-growing population of young people, and the only way to engage them actively is creating the enabling environment. And one way of creating this enabling environment is building strong enterprises. We have traditional enterprises that are established, we have multinationals in Africa. We'll talk about small, medium enterprises that are built and developed through ideas that are turned to wealth creation, employing people, and also utilizing skills and potentials. Presently, we are seeing some initiatives in Nigeria, in South Africa, and Rwanda. And it is hoped that this will be devoid of political influence so that they will gain traction and begin to add value to society. We look now at a very important issue, the inflation rate in Africa. And we're going to use four economies in focus. Nigeria, recently rebased as the largest economy in Africa, 26th largest in the world, has its inflation rate rising and is now at 8.3%. South Africa, the second largest economy in Africa and number two competitive economy in Africa with a position of number 56, has its inflation rate at 6.55%. If we also look at Kenya, Kenya at the moment is 7.67% in inflation rate. From these four countries, it is clear that African countries need to take seriously the issue of inflation rates that is rising. The central banks need to readjust and look at monetary policy and ensure that it doesn't get to the level where it will create another austerity experience or crisis, which we'll look back in the 70s. And then we go to the issue of the rising tide of insurgency and security in the continent. Just last week, African leaders gathered in Nairobi, Kenya, to look at ways of improving security and tackling the terrorism perpetrated by groups like Boko Haram, Al-Shabaab, and even the Maghreb forces. There is need for African leaders to work together, collaborate, even the institutions, working assiduously to tackle this tide that seems to negate or truncate the prospect for Africa's rising. Terrorism, especially in Nigeria, in Kenya, and even in Somalia, is threatening the economy and also creating a lot of concerns for foreign investments. And finally, one issue that Africa must take seriously is regional collaboration. Regional collaboration is important, as we see in Europe and even in Southeast Asia, where challenges come, for example, like a pandemic. The recent development that has come through Ebola in the last 3 months has created a lot of concern for the region. It's even tending to affect production, tending to affect trade, and also investment in the continent. It is expected that despite the pandemic, which of course has hit three countries, Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea, and the concern that borders need to be closed to curtail movement of people, this should be handled in a matured manner to avoid schisms or tensions or diplomatic row. Africa is a continent that can harness its potentials effectively through collaborations. And in this angle, we propose that an Africa Rapid Response for Ebola initiative be adopted, coordinated through the health ministers and also the support of governments to see how medical personnel, especially in these three countries which have overwhelming public health institutions framework and need more support from other African countries, will gain that support, which will also attract more foreign assistance where necessary in terms of the protective health equipment and materials for the health workers, and also the necessary medications and drugs which can be sent to treat the patients, as well as infrastructure, the quarantine areas, and security required to ensure that the situation does not get out of hand. Africa will first set the pace for the globe to engage and tackle this menace. And if it's done properly, other situations or exigencies will be tackled through effective collaboration in the region. This is how Africa can begin to show its preparedness, to turn its prospects, to turn its potentials, to turn its new profile as a key investment hub and the last frontier to wealth and general well-being of its citizens. And this is how Africa will become the game changer in the 21st century. This, we hope, will be taken to note. Thank you for this edition. It's been a great time interacting with you on Africa, and we believe that this story will change the landscape. For further details and engagement on our website, you can log on to www.webtvng.com or our social media handles, Facebook and Twitter. Also, we have daily news analysis from our #1 minute news from Preoshare Nigeria. Logging on to preoshareng.com and you get clear insights on the market, economy, finance analysis that are clear, incisive and accurate. Till next edition, thank you for watching and have a great day. Thank you.